Welcome back. This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan, back in the saddle. Mark Shields, David Brooks, back from vacation. Did you have a good time?
I was in the saddle. We're riding horses in Montana.
Really?
Horses finally gave up.
And you were out for a couple of weeks, but you were back last week as well.
I was up in Cape Cod. Yes.
Shucking oysters?
No, as a matter of fact, just enjoying.
Okay. The polo season is in full swing.
Yeah, the polo season.
Okay, a couple of big topics in D.C. this week that aren't really, about the administration per se. Ken Mehlman, from former RNC chair, decides to tell former colleagues and friends that he is gay. The question that I really have is, besides, is this a Republican or Democrat issue, really, are we still in a society where being out curtails your opportunities for public leadership?
Well, he didn't hold elective office. He was head of the RNC. Whether he would have made it running for office, I'm not sure about.
A leadership position in the public eye.
The reaction among people who I think were in Republican circles and knew him, like most of us did, was, oh, I never thought about that. That's interesting. Move on. And I don't think there's been much shock and horror. Maybe different than 5 years ago, when I think the issue was hotter and public opinion has moved on this. So I would say the reaction is, oh, that's interesting and nice to know and good for him and move on.
One of the reasons the issue was hotter 5 or 6 years ago was that the Bush campaign, which Ken Mehlman ran, made same-sex marriage an organizing principle as a get-out-the-vote effort to put it on a constitutional amendment on ballots in every major presidential state, battleground state. It was conceived by Karl Rove and implemented by Mark Mehlman. So there had to be a discomfort level at the very least. What I find fascinating is that the Bush-Cheney ticket, which used that device, Dick Cheney, the vice president, has since come out against a constitutional amendment banning same-sex marriage, again, because of the personal experience, his own daughter. Laura Bush, the First Lady, has now come out in favor of same-sex marriage. And now Ken Mehlman, which it probably indicates a change in the country, but it doesn't rewrite what happened in 2004. Yeah.
There was, maybe underline that. I remember in the 2000 convention, there was a meeting of the Log Cabin Republicans, which is a gay Republican organization, and there were a lot of big Bush people there. I remember Mary Madeline spoke, and it was people had buttons, and Bush had said something in the course of the campaign that when he had met with more gay people, he was a better man. And the button was, I'm a better man. And that was in the first Bush campaign, and that was all gone in the second campaign. That much is true.
Okay. Turning to far more pressing issues, the District of Columbia, Strasburg, the pitcher for the Nationals. Shoulder surgery? Forearm surgery? What is it called?
The Tommy John.
The Tommy John surgery.
Right.
This has had a serious impact on the belt.
It's an enormous downer. If you get economic numbers of the stock market or anything of the sort, unemployment, in Washington, this is a real depressing story. Stephen Strasburg was, and may still be, the real Barack Obama. He brought people together across party line, across ideological line, labor and management. They all stood and cheered as one. And he brought the city together and the whole entire community of Washington together. And the idea of his career being threatened, and this is a career-threatening surgery. It's named for Tommy John, a pitcher who did come back after the surgery, it's no guarantee that he will ever return to that marvelous debut he had.
Yeah, the people do come back. Jim Andrews is the great surgeon who does most of it. And people come back, they tend to come back with more velocity. But that's because they work out a lot harder after the surgery. What they don't come back with is the movement on the pitches. That you can't control. So Dwight Gooden, who had this phenomenal opening of his career, had a God-given loose shoulder, and it created incredible movement on the pitches. And after some surgery, he never had that again.
Wow. See what you learn here?
We see, we saw the season, which Mark said was unbelievable for Washington. We never have great sports here. And that may be gone. But on the other hand, people come back and sometimes are better than ever, so that could happen too.
And you have seen this, David Brooks, but Please, if you could read from this fine publication, Mark Shields, what's under the
this
caption?
This is Onion. It's a great American publication, and is in print. It says is a picture of David. Can you see that, Quinn? Can you pick it up?
That was taken. Okay. That's my bar mitzvah picture.
It was actually junior high graduation. It said most promising to succeed in high school. No, it says superhero never around when mild-mannered journalist David Brooks is. Now, this is suggesting a Clark Kent similarity, which makes me Lois Lane, I guess. I don't know. But I mean, that's it. I've always thought he was really Superman.
I'm resenting the mild-mannered reputation I'm now getting. I'm going to start a fight with Mark on the show.
Well, this was from the, we're not making this up, this is in the August 19, 2010, volume 461, 46, issue 33, just in case you want to check for yourselves whether or not David Brooks is a mild-mannered journalist/superhero. This is the Rundown. In the meantime, Mark Shields, David Brooks, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.